The Art of Life. First we will read this aloud and then we will try to understand it. The Art of Life. Life beautifully lived is an art. Yes, whether we will or not, we are artists. To each has been given by a benevolent creator the raw materials out of which life is made. What does the writer say here? Living life is an art. Whether we want or not, whether we desire or not, whether we plan or not, whether we agree or not, but life beautifully lived is an art. And we all are artists. And everyone is given a lot of qualities. I'm sure you have noticed, you have a lot of qualities. Everyone else that you come across, he or she has some or the other qualities, right? So everyone has lots of qualities, lots of skills. Even those who are physically challenged, they may have some special qualities, right? So to each has been given by a benevolent creator. Creator means God or nature or universe, whatever you call it. The raw material is available with you. And using that raw material, you have to make your life. When we begin our task of living, these raw materials are in the rough, as a stone just taken from the quarry. You may have some skill, some talent, but it is in raw form. You have to polish it, you have to hone your skills, sharpen your skills, right? So your raw material, your talent is like a stone just taken from the quarry, a shapeless mass, often unattractive and seemingly with very limited possibilities. So that raw material, the primary skill that you have, the talent that you have, it has to be sharpened, otherwise it is just a shapeless mass. But that mass, that shapeless mass is awaiting, that means waiting for, awaiting the skill of the master artist. And who is that master artist? You. You are the master artist, right? Michelangelo, the great artist of the Renaissance, once said he could see an angel on the rugged stone on which he was working. Michelangelo, the greatest artist, one of the greatest artists we have seen on earth. Now, when he saw a rugged stone, he did not see it actually as a stone. He saw the final product, that angel that he was planning to carve out. That means he had that goal in mind right from the beginning, even when he had the raw material. So he was able to see that final product on that particular, in that particular stone, and that his task was to liberate it. So to achieve that goal, he had to work, right? This is the business of life, namely to make out of the rough materials of daily opportunity the shapeless mass of the past, a life that is attractive and beautiful and of enduring value. That means using all these rough materials. What are the rough materials for us? Daily opportunities, right? Whatever experience we have earned, right? The past is our experience. So using that past experience, using daily opportunities, we have to create a life that is good, that is valuable. Many are merely dabbling around, making some strange monstrosity, some childish caricature, some ludicrously grotesque figure, which excites only a sense of humor or of pathos because of its incongruity. That means many people, they are just wasting their time. They are roaming here and there. They have talent. Everyone has talents, but not everyone is able to sharpen their skills or grow in their life. So they are just wasting their time, creating something stupid, grotesque, childish. And sometimes we feel pity for such people because we feel that they are wasting their talent, right? So many are like that. Others are content to copy life after a common pattern with no skill of artistry and no sense of life's true values. So there are some other people who just copy somebody's life. They may have some person in mind and they want to become like that. They just try to copy. And there is no skill of artistry, nothing creative, nothing innovative, right? And they don't have a true sense of life's values. A few, in harmony with Father's perfect plan, are creating masterpieces of exquisite beauty, of lasting enjoyment, and of rare accomplishment, which will be classic in the annals of the history of man. That means only a few people, out of 1,000, maybe 2-3 people, who are different from the rest, positively different from the rest. And what do? They work in harmony with Father's perfect plan. That means whatever nature has given them, accordingly they will work hard and they will create masterpieces, exquisite beauty, something which will be rare. How many people write every day on earth? Thousands of people. Does everyone become a great poet or a great writer? No. Everyone, like hundreds of people, they draw every day. Does everyone become an artist? No. So only a few people, right? Only a few people, they work in harmony with nature's plan and they create masterpieces, right? And such things will be classic. They will be classic in the history of man. People will remember them for a long time. What Wordsworth wrote, Shakespeare wrote hundreds of years ago, even today we read and we enjoy, right? Whether our lives are beautiful and sublime or commonplace and unattractive depends to a large extent upon our skill as artists, our concept of the beautiful, and our appreciation of the true values of life. So who will decide whether our lives are great or ordinary, right? Whether remarkable or commonplace? Who will decide? Or what will decide? So that is dependent on our skill as artists, number one. Number two, our concept of the beautiful. What do we call beautiful, right? That concept. And our appreciation of the true values of life. What values do we appreciate in life? So all these things will decide how you live your life. Creative art demands the price of discipline. This is very nice. Creative art, it is not just an effortless thing. Something people sometimes say, he has a God gift, that's why he is able to do this work or that work. It is not just like that. God gift is there, okay, but after that what? You demand, creative art demands the price of discipline, right? Of hard work and of eternal persistence means working, even if you fail on the way a few times, but still you keep working. That is eternal persistence. And when you have all these things, discipline, hard work and persistence is tenacity. You continue working in spite of your problems. So when you have these three things, then there is a possibility of making a good life. True art is the product of skill in creative expression, which is innate. What is true art? True art is the product of skill in creative expression, which is innate, and to which has been added long years of study, of practice, and of painstaking evaluations. That means whatever skill or talent you have, to that you have to add what? Long years of study and practice, and you have to evaluate your performance again and again at regular intervals. Right? Then only you will know whether you have really grown or not, whether you have really developed or not. And if you do it over a long period of time, for years and years, then you will be able to create a masterpiece. right? Then you can say you have lived your life to the full. So this was The Art of Life, by created by Ira D Schogam, one of the masterpieces in English literature, right? So I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you very much.